so excited. I'm so excited. I'm so excited.
Why am I so excited, you ask?
Well, reason number one. Guess who I just read is coming out of retirement? Gronkowski! The Gronk is coming back. And guess where he's going? That's right, he's going to Tampa Bay. The boys will be back in town. Tom Gronkowski. Reason number two, because we're at our last day for our 1 foot challenge. So stick around.
Hey everybody, I'm James. I started this channel because one day I woke up and realized I was 43, but felt like I was 83. Every day my body could do one less thing than it could do the day before. So if you're like me and you've had enough, then put on your shoes and welcome to Getting Stronger.
Hey guys, welcome back to Getting Stronger. And that's right, today is officially the last day of our 1 foot challenge. Over the last 30 days, we've been learning all these different individual movements, exercises. We've learned 19 so far, and today is number 20. The exercise for today, it's gonna be in and out, kind of plank, kind of bear crawl with a row. Remember the other day when I showed you the rocking chair? Well, it's the same starting position. This is step one. Step two is going to be doing an in and out motion. For those of you who are new, just bring your feet back in a little bit. Shorten the motion. For those of you who are advanced, when you bring your knees in, bring them all the way up to your elbows. And for those of you who are really advanced and you want to incorporate the row, let me show you how it would look in its entirety, and then we'll back up and try to break it down. Okay, so this is tough because when you do the roll, you're actually turning it into a four count cadence, which means you're doing four repetitions to make one count. So you're going one, two, three, and one. So you're doing four to make one. Now, how you initiate the roll is a little tricky. What you have to do is when you come onto that back beat, you actually have to cross your feet. Check it out. So back and two, back and three, but it's back. Watch again. Back and two, back and three, but it's back and four, right? So on that back beat, you cross your feet. Watch how this looks. It's back and back. See how I'm crossing? Back, and on the and beat, your butt hits the floor. Back, and on the fourth beat, roll. So you initiate the move by crossing your feet, and then you finish the move by throwing the other foot over the top. Watch closely. Back. See my right? Back, and now my left is going to swing over. And that completes the repetition. Let me do a couple of complete reps to show you how this would look when I'm flowing. Dog, that is hard. Nah, I'm just kidding. It's really easy. Once you get into the rhythm, you're gonna start being like boom to the right, boom to the left. You're gonna feel like you're in the NFL, right? You're gonna be on the front line. and that guy's gonna come this way, boom, you're gonna drop and roll. Then somebody's coming around the right side, you're gonna boom, drop, and you're gonna roll, and you're gonna be there. I love this exercise because at its core, it makes us move. And I love movement. I love tumbling, I love rolling, I love anything that really forces me to have to really develop the ability to control my body in space. That's what this channel is about. It's about making your everyday better.
Hey, Frank. Hey, Larry. How's it going, Betty? How are the kids?
Whoa, I tripped. Whoa.
It's a good thing James, the best YouTuber in the world, taught me how to roll, or I might have broke something.
Plus, you never know when you're gonna get that invitation to the world's annual breakdancing competition. So that's it for today's video. And that's the end of this 1 foot challenge for today. And that brings the whole challenge to an end. You know, in all seriousness, I just really hope that you took one thing away from this 1 foot challenge. And that's that by making some very small changes every day, you can radically alter the course of your life. I remember in the Navy when we were doing target practice and learning to shoot, I remember that even when our sight was off just by millimeters, whenever the bullet had to travel a distance, like 100 meters, 200 meters, whatever, the bullet with every foot or two would begin to really stray further and further. Those millimeters really began to add up. So by the time the bullet got down to the target, that round was 15, 20, 30 feet off of the target. How did it get 30 feet off the target when the sight was only a millimeter off? Well, it's because those millimeters add up. Our decisions every day add up. You know, there's a funny Bible verse that says that it's the little foxes that spoil the vine, right? It's kind of weird, right? The little foxes. So what is that trying to tell us? It's telling us that it's the little decisions that add up over the course of a lifetime that really affect where we're gonna end up, whether we're gonna have a good life or a bad life, whether we're going to be healthy or whether we're going to be sick. So please remember that moving forward, it's not the big things in life that make the difference. It's the little steps. It's that putting 1 foot. Nah, I'm not gonna play the song. You get the point. It's putting the 1 foot in front of the other, these little choices that are really gonna affect the outcome of our lives. So that's it. I hope you enjoyed today's video. I hope you enjoyed the entire challenge. If you did, make sure you give us a big thumbs up, hit the subscribe button, and hit the notification bell so you never miss an episode. And if you missed any episodes, don't worry, go back. They're on YouTube. You can watch them over and over. If you're really a beginner, my advice is take one day's exercise, one challenge, and practice it all week. Really master the basics. If you take all 20 exercises and practice one exercise a week, it'll take you 20 weeks, so almost half a year. But that's okay, because you can take the first 6 months of your year to really learn and master these basic exercises. What you'd be doing is laying down a foundation. The second 6 months, you can start building upon that foundation. You can start grouping these individual exercises together and create circuits. My advice is when you do that, start with just two exercises. Create a two-station circuit. Maybe pick an upper body and a lower body. Pick a lower body and a core. Pick a core and an upper body. It doesn't matter, but start with just two exercises, two stations. Do station one for 20 seconds. Move to station two for 20 seconds, take a break for 20 seconds, and then roll it back. You wanna get to the point where you can do this for say 10 minutes. Then you wanna build endurance and get to where you can do it for 15, 20 minutes. So eventually you wanna get so good at this that you could actually do a workout where you run through the circuit for 45 to 50 minutes straight. And once you do that, you know what the next step is, right? That's right. You wanna throw in a third station. So now you can put together a three-station circuit. Upper body, core, lower body. The target for today's challenge is you wanna do 50. So if you're doing the regular version, that means you would count them like this. Back one, back two, back three, etc. But if you're advanced and you're doing the roll, you actually want to count only the roll as a count. So you're actually gonna do four repetitions. So you're gonna go back one, back two, back three, back and roll. That roll is one repetition. And if you really wanna take this up another notch, count only a roll to the right and a roll to the left as a rep. So you would go back one, back two, back three, back and roll to the left, back one, back two, back three, back roll to the right. So now you're back to the starting position and that's one count. Now that's super hard. Don't do that. Are you crazy? I don't even wanna do that. So that's it, I'm done. I've showed you how to do them. I'm gonna go do mine now. You enjoy your day, be safe, take your time, be smart, and make sure that before you go to bed tonight, before you hit that rack, you knock these things out. You don't wanna go to bed on our last day of this 1 foot challenge, not completing the day's task. I'm off to create my next challenge to make your life better. Until then, remember, Psalms 139, verse 14. You guys should know this verse by now. Each and every one of us were fearfully and wonderfully made, and we came from the hand of our Creator above. Our Heavenly Father loves us. He loves you, and He wants you to have the best life possible, filled with joy and laughter, happiness, and health. But no matter how much God wishes these things for us, you know what I'm gonna say. We have to do our part. That means making good choices every day about what we eat and how we spend our time. We need to choose to eat well. A banana instead of a cookie, water instead of tea, coffee, beer. And we need to choose to get up off the couch, turn off that TV, and get outside and get some exercise every single day. So for the rest of this day, whatever you eat, whatever you drink, and whatever you do, just keep getting stronger. And I'll see you guys back again for our next episode.